Welcome back to Al Jazeera America. I'm Erica Pitsey. We're getting emotional reaction this morning to news that Darren Wilson has resigned. The officer who shot and killed Michael Brown stepping down immediately just days after a grand jury's decision not to indict him. But the news of Wilson's resignation did not dispel anger in the Ferguson community, where tensions boiled over outside the Ferguson Police Department. Jonathan Martin is live in Ferguson for us this morning. Good morning to you, Jonathan. What are you seeing and hearing from people in response to this resignation? And as the Kurds continue to fight ISIL, they face an internal threat as well. Hundreds of young Kurdish men have joined ISIL, influenced by online propaganda or after receiving encouragement from local fighters. The Justice Department says Native American tribes will soon be allowed to grow and sell marijuana on federally recognized reservations. And there are also reports of the gunmen wearing masks, armed with automatic weapons, at least one rocket launcher, escaping by hijacking a car. Now, French President Francois Hollande is calling it a terror attack and immediately raised its terror alert to the highest level. U.S. Special Forces reportedly carried out a raid on an al-Qaeda hideout in Yemen and rescued 8 hostages. Health officials in the U.S. are now fighting Ebola on 2 fronts. They're working to stop the virus from spreading, and they're also trying to head off a public panic. According to the World Health Organization, this outbreak has claimed 4,555 lives, nearly all of them in West Africa. To date, only 2 people have contracted the disease in this country. Both are nurses who cared for Ebola victim Thomas Eric Duncan. But fear is contagious. Today, President Obama used his weekly address to urge people to resist the hysteria. Well, let's go now to the Kennedy Space Center in Cape Canaveral, Florida, where the countdown to launch for NASA's Orion spacecraft is now underway. This test flight is the first step on a possible manned mission to Mars. The unmanned capsule is due to orbit the Earth twice during the course of its 4.5-hour mission. Orion is expected to travel 3,600 miles into space. The spacecraft is equipped with 1,000 sensors. Here it comes. Let's listen in.
And liftoff at dawn. The dawn of Orion and a new era of American space exploration.
Well, John, the town of Ferguson waiting for days for a decision to come down. The announcement made at night during a holiday week. How do you think that impacted the protests? Officer Wilson put out a statement and he said, you know, thanking people for, you know, their support and said, I'd love to hug each and every one of you, but I've got to, keep safe and keep my family safe and stay indoors and stay out of the public. Do you think he's going to have to stay out of law enforcement? Is his career over?
Yes.
And Jim, this is Erica. You know, you say that Al-Qaeda and ISIL are somewhat collaborating, but do you also think that they're somewhat competing to maybe strike fear in the mindsets of Westerners? Real quick, Police Commissioner Bill Bratton just yesterday had said, stepped up to the microphone and very emphatically said, can you name one mayor in the history of this city that has not had a battle with the police union? Can you, in your 30 years?
The commissioner was 1,000% correct when he made that comment.
And in that game, Jeter was showered with love from the most unlikely group of fans. I would know because I am one. John Henry Smith is here with more.
Pitsy, by the way, who won the game?
The Yankees, of course. Come on. They were going to, of course, make that happen.
But and did I say my Nats are in the playoffs this year? I just want to
put that out.
Don't start with me. Let's take a look at some of the other stories.
Coming up in the next hour of Al Jazeera, finding future scientists in the most remote parts of India, the program to help kids learn their full potential through opportunities they might not have otherwise. Keep it here. I'm back with you in just a minute for the next hour of Al Jazeera America.